How's it going, everybody? It's Dan from Hali back with another video for you today. And if this is your first time joining me, you're in for a ride because I do reaction videos at least 5 days a week, twice daily. And I have a video for you today. This is SB19 MAPA. And I'm told that this is one of the songs to be listening to by SB19. It was requested a whole lot on my first couple videos. I did Bazinga, I did What? And everybody wants to see what I think of MAPA, so I am going to be doing that for you very, very shortly here in this video. But beforehand, let's talk about requests, because there's a couple ways that you can do them. You can send your requests down in the comments section, and you can always do that. I'm always up for taking new requests and trying out new artists. But if you want to cut the line, skip the line a little bit, and cut to the front, you can go down to the description, a link to my... PayPal is down there. You can put down a donation to get a request, or you can join me over at patreon.com/DanFromHali, where you can join up, become a patron, support this channel, get early access to a couple of my videos per week, as well as get a guaranteed reaction request in. So if you have any other SB19 requests and you think that I should be reacting to them like right now, that's exactly how you should do them. Otherwise, I'm eventually going to do them anyway in my own leisure. So you're not losing out. It's just an extra way if you want to show some support for the channel. That is all. But you're supporting me enough just by watching this, and I want you to know that. So guys, SB19, MAPA, here it is. I'm told it's a little on the sad side. I think somebody or a couple people said that in the comments. Let's do it. Let's just get into it. Okay, I got captions on just in case. Sounds almost nursery rhymey. Mama, kamusta na dina? Tayo laging nagkikita, miss na kita sobra. Lagi na lang kami ang nauuna. Di ba pwedeng ikaw muna, akin ang pangamba? Dahil ikaw ang aking mata, sa tuwing mundo'y nag-iibang dahilan ng aking paghinga. Kaya huwag mag-alala, ipikit ang iyong mata, tanga, pahinga muna, ako nang bahala. Labis pa sa labis ang iyong nagawa, mama, pahinga muna, ako na. This is interesting to me. I think this video is so cool. I really like the simple animation of it. The song itself is beautiful. This is an absolutely beautiful ballad with some playful music and flow to the lyrics. I really, really like this. I mentioned during my reaction to What that these guys, everybody in the group, is very distinct. They stand out, and they all have absolutely beautiful voices to them. I mean, they're so smooth. Oh God, I'm really enjoying these reactions to SB19. Can't wait to do more, and I can't wait to press play and hear this. This is wonderful. And I wasn't expecting this. I know somebody said that it was about parents and stuff like that. But this is a wonderful song. Alright, let's press play. Papa, naaalala mo pa ba? Nung ako'y bata pa, diba? Aking puso yung hinanda sa mga bagay na All right, I need a second here. Whew. Okay, I think I'm good. That was beautiful. That was an absolutely beautiful ballad about a very beautiful subject. You know, not forgetting where you came from and always remembering what was taught to you and the memories that you have and, you know, all the things that you did with your family, with your mom and dad. Got me watering a little bit. Oh, it happens once in a while. Just means that you really connect with the song. I did, unfortunately. I had done a reaction here early on my channel to a song called A Million Years from Angelina Jordan. And it actually took me a half hour to calm myself down and give the closing of the video, because I was an absolute wreck. Because my childhood was my childhood for me is kind of a touchy subject, especially when talking about dads and stuff like that. Because up until I was, you know, a teenager, I didn't know my biological father, and we had a fairly short relationship. He stepped in and he tried to support me as much as he could. But as I grew up and, you know, became an adult, it turned more into a thing where he thought that support was just giving me money. That's kind of what was important to him, was the monetary aspect of it. And as a child, I had a strained relationship with my stepdad. So, you know, the whole fatherhood, I guess, is important to me. Fatherhood is something that I want for myself. I want to be able to provide for my kid the way that my biological father was never able to provide for me. And the man tried. Mine tried. I don't want to take that away from him. It's just, I don't think fatherhood is kind of what he wanted. He loves family, and he is an absolute incredible person, so I can't take that away from him. It's just, he's not, yeah, anyway. So, it was weird when I was a kid. My brother, he was into hockey and baseball and all that stuff, and my father, or my stepdad, I should say, was always taking him, my stepbrother, to baseball games and hockey games and going away on tournaments and stuff like that. And he was he's a politician. He was a politician for 10 years. He was MLA, and he was always traveling from our hometown of Blaise Bay to Halifax, which is where I live now. And he'd be gone while legislature was in session. He was gone for 5 days a week. He'd be coming home for Saturday and Sunday and leave early Monday morning, sometimes even Sunday afternoon. Which meant, my mother was left doing everything. And when it wasn't my mother, and once my brother grew up, it was my job to look after my sister. And it was rough. It really left a strange relationship with my father, especially when I became a teenager, because that's a lot to put on kids. And my brother did it for me and my sister when he was still home, and then it was on me, because raising a family and being a part of a family dynamic isn't something to just put on one person. And, when you're kids, you should have that family there. But he was trying to provide for a family, and that's something that I didn't appreciate and respect up until, God, just a few years ago. We had some issues in the family, and once that kind of smoke settled and we found a new family dynamic, I really started to take stock and appreciate all the stuff that my stepfather, my father, for all intents and purposes. I call him dad and father. I usually don't refer to him as stepdad, because he's the man that raised me. So I was able to take stock and appreciate and respect all that he's done for the family, all the lessons he taught me on maybe not how to be a good kid because he wasn't there as much as he wanted to be, but how to be a good man, become a good person. So yeah, that's the whole subject of being a kid and having family around is something that means something different to me as a person. Because I kind of had to traverse that, as far as I'm concerned, on my own. I did not make it easy for my dad, my stepdad, to parent me. He had a lot of trouble with me because I was trouble. The place where I grew up, the little neighborhood was rough. It was fighting. It was always fighting. So I was always getting in trouble. I was always in the principal's office. I was always in detention. Unfortunately, I didn't make it easy for him as I was a teenager. And then as a young adult, I rebelled against him because, to me, he wasn't around, so why should I cut him any slack? That's the way that I kind of looked at it. But in a way, that's something that it took time for me to learn that I was wrong as a kid. And he was doing his best. He was trying to earn. He sacrificed so much for our family. So much. In the end, He's still alive. So I don't mean in the end as in he's not with me anymore. But in the end, he ended up having to sacrifice his career, or feeling like he had to sacrifice his career, his personal life, his well-being, his health, all to put money on our table, to put to put food on our table, to put money in the bank account, to provide a roof for us to live under. And I couldn't see that when I was a kid, right? Because he has so much pride. Fathers, that's the thing about fathers. They're like cats, right? They don't want to show you that they're injured. They don't want to show you that they're down. They want to look tough. They want to look the part of the dad. So while dad was sacrificing everything for us, he didn't let us see exactly what he was sacrificing, so I didn't have the chance to really appreciate it until it was too late. But fortunately, I still have years with him left. And God, he's a great man. Oh, I'm a mess. I didn't think that was going to hit me. All right, that's getting me in the throat now. So that's going to be it for me, guys. Thank you so much for checking this out. Of course, now I'm starting to calm down from it. But what a powerful song. Oh, no. We're done. We're done with the song. That's gonna bring me back to that. Cool. Really powerful song. Really, really well performed. That's three absolute bangers in a row from SB19. Can't wait to react to some more. And I can't wait to see you guys at the next one. But until then, bye.